Hi, I'm Nicolas Garnier. I'm a developer advocate for Google Drive. Today, I want to show you how web applications can integrate deeply with Google Drive using the Google Drive SDK. This will allow your application to take advantage of Drive's user-managed storage, integrate with the Google Drive Online File Explorer, and potentially leverage the billions of files that are currently stored in users' Drive. We will demonstrate how to do that by implementing and integrating a web-based text editor. But first, it is important to understand what can be achieved by integrating your web application with Google Drive. So we're going to go through a few scenarios showcasing how apps can integrate with Google Drive today. Let's now go to Google Drive File Explorer. As you probably know, Google Drive offers a way to synchronize your files to your devices and desktop computers. Our user currently has a few images stored in his drive already. We can see one of them here. The user now wants to edit that image, and for that, he has installed Cloud Paint. Cloud Paint is a third-party image editor that offers a Google Drive integration. All that the user has to do is right-click on the file and choose to open it with Cloud Paint. The user gets redirected to the application and is displayed with the image, which he can edit. Here, let's edit it. When the user saves the image, the modified image gets saved directly on Google Drive. Here, if we go back to Google Drive and have a look at the image, as you can see, we've got the modified image directly in Google Drive. Similarly, we can also create an image through the Create menu with Cloud Paint. We're going to call it Mr. Potato. Let me draw something using my awesome drawing skills and click Save. As you can see in my drive, the new file has been created. Let's just have a look. And here we can see Mr. Potato. All of that was done in the cloud. There was no manual file manipulation needed. I didn't have to download the file from Drive and upload the file back to the tool. All that file creation and data exchange were done server to server using the Google Drive API. This is the kind of experience that Google Drive integrated applications are able to offer to their users. So now we are going to see how to create a Drive application. For the purpose of this webinar, we will implement and integrate a web-based text editor that we will call Dr. Edit. Prior to coding, there are two things that you need to do. First, you need to register your application, and then list your application. To register your application, you have to go to the Google APIs console, create a new project, and enable the Google Drive API and the Google Drive SDK. Then you need to create OAuth 2 credentials. You would usually have to select web applications and provide the URL at which your app is hosted. In our case, it's going to be Dr. Edit. Your OAuth 2 credentials are now ready. You also need to configure the Google Drive specific features. You can do that in the Drive SDK section. You'll have to fill in some information about your application and provide some icons. Most of this is pretty straightforward. In this example, I have already configured my app, but let me go through a few of these fields that need special attention. The open URL is the URL to which we will redirect users when they open a file with your app. You will have to make sure the open URL is listed in the redirect URIs of your OAuth 2 client ID. This is because we do the redirect through an OAuth 2 flow using the client ID, and therefore the URL needs to be listed as a valid redirect URI. You need to list the MIME types and the extension that the app can open. For our app, we simply listed the basic text file MIME type and the TXT extension. It is usually best to list both MIME type and extensions. If your app supports creating new files, which is the case for Dr. Edit, you will need to specify the URL that will handle such requests. Make sure that the URL is also listed as a valid redirect URI of your client ID. Typically, you will need access to the user's email or ID, and we will explain later why. So we've added the user info profile scope here. You don't need to list the Google Drive API scope, as the drive.file scope is implicit. That default scope gives you access to Drive files created by your application or file that has been opened through the Google Drive UI with your application. It is important to be aware of this per file security model. Now, the second thing you need to do is create a Chrome Web Store listing. You need that listing to be able to install app to some Drive accounts so that you can initiate, open, and create file actions from Drive. Currently, all Drive apps are distributed and installable through the Chrome Web Store. This is the Chrome Web Store. In the developer dashboard, you can create new listing. This is like creating any other Chrome Web Store listing, except that you will need to add two special lines to your Chrome Web Store apps manifest file. You need to specify the Google Drive container and also your API console apps ID. To create your listing, you will need to upload a few mandatory assets like icon, screenshots, promo image. Also enter a description, verify that you are the owner of the website, and so on. To save time, I have already prepared the Chrome Web Store listing for Dr. Edit. Once these are done, make sure that you publish your listing only to a list of trusted testers while your Drive application is in development. This is important so that your listing does not appear in the public list of available Drive apps while not finished. Once your listing is ready and published to trusted testers, just install your app, and the next time you open Google Drive in your browser, you will get a notification that the app has been installed, and you will be able to open supported files with the app. In our case, text file. You will also be able to create files with the app through the Create menu. So if you choose to create a file with Dr. Edit, Drive initiates an OAuth2 flow, and since this is the first time that we are using the app, we are prompted to authorize Dr. Edit for Google Drive file access, and also for the extra scopes that were listed in the APIs console. After the user grants access, he is redirected to your application Create with URL, where we first need to handle authorization to the API. There will be two parameters passed in the URL. The first parameter contains the OAuth code, and the second is the state parameter, which contains a JSON object containing two attributes. The first one simply states which action was triggered on Drive, in this case a create new file action. The second is the ID of the parent folder that was currently being displayed in the Drive UI. This is provided so that the file created can be saved directly to the currently opened folder. So now we need to finish the OAuth2 flow. This means exchanging the OAuth code for tokens. In that case, we will get an access token and a refresh token. As you can see here, this is pretty easy to do using our client libraries. After initializing a few static objects, the exchange is done in one line of code. In Google OAuth2 protected APIs, the access token allows you to use the API for 1 hour, and the refresh token allows you to extend that by getting new access tokens. This is important because you will need the refresh token if your application needs to use the API for more than an hour, which is the case for Dr. Edit. Now, what you need to do is save this refresh token. That's basically because we get a refresh token only the first time a user opens the application in Drive. Subsequent times, the user will not be prompted for the OAuth2 grant screen, and we will only get an access token. So, in order to be able to retrieve the refresh token in the future, we need to save it against the ID of the user. And what we do here is get the ID of the user through the user info API. Alternatively, you could also use the email of that user, but the ID is a little more robust because it will never change. We now can save the refresh token using the user ID as the table key. Just use your preferred database. For instance, in an App Engine environment, you could simply save it to the App Engine data store. We now have an access token and a refresh token, which we just saved. At that point, we save the refresh token and the access token to the session and pass the folder ID as a request parameter. Then we display the UI of the web-based text editor. Let's choose a name for the new file and then enter some text. Let's simply call it Hello World. The web-based text editor used in this sample is called ACE. ACE is open source, fully client-side and JavaScript-based. To be able to use ACE with Drive, we simply hooked up ACE's JavaScript API to some AJAX call to our backend, which handles the reading and writing of Drive files. So when the Save button is clicked, what happens is we send the content of the text file to our server-side code through an AJAX call. Server-side, we receive the content of the new file, its name, description, and the destination folder ID through an AJAX call. Then, you simply need these few lines of code to create the file on Google Drive using our client libraries. There are two parts to a Drive file, the metadata and the actual file's content. We first set some metadata, such as the file, the name, the description, MIME type, and parent folder. Then, in the same request, both the metadata and the file's content are sent to the Drive API to create the file. Now, let's go back to the Drive Explorer, and as you can see, the text file that was just created is here. Now, let's see how to handle the other integration point, which is opening an existing file with your app. So if we choose to open a Drive file with DrEdit, again, Drive will trigger an OAuth2 flow, but your users won't see the grand screen this time because we have approved the application earlier. So all subsequent OAuth flow for that app will skip the approval screen, and you will be automatically redirected to the open URL of the app. Again, there will be two parameters passed in the URL. The first parameter contains the OAuth code, and the second contains a JSON object again, still containing two attributes. The first one indicates that the action triggered on Drive is an open with. The second is an array of ID of the files that have been opened. It is an array because you can enable a feature that will let your users open multiple files with your app, if you choose so. Since this is not the first time the user authorizes the app, exchanging the code will only return an access token and a refresh token. Now you have a refresh token saved in your database from the first time the user authorized. So to get it, you would typically get the user ID using the access token to call the user info API as we've seen earlier. And then pull the refresh token from your local database using the user ID. That way we can have access to the API for more than the expiration period of the access token, which is 1 hour. Note that all of our client libraries handle refreshing the access token automatically if you passed a refresh token. Again, we save the refresh token and the access token to the session and pass the file ID as a request parameter. Then we display the UI of the web-based text editor. Now, the editor queries an AJAX endpoint on your backend that will load the file's content, which we can display in ACE. So what happens here is that we have a servlet serving the AJAX requests that will use the API to read the file. After handling the authorization and initializing the Drive service, this is done in two steps. First, read the file's metadata. This gives us important info like the file's name and also the download URL, which is where the file's content is located. So then, we download the file's content using an authorized request to the download URL and return that to the AJAX call. Here it is, the content of the file is being displayed client-side in the UI. This is it! Your app now has basic Google Drive functionalities. It can open files from Drive, as well as create files from Drive. Don't forget to check our online documentation for more details. You will also find the sources for this simple application used in this video. It is available in 5 languages. Thanks for watching!